website is called bachatawithcarlos.com, and it's my newest project to where I break the website down into four different sections. So there's four different tabs. It's broken down into musicality, timing, partner work, and footwork. And so, and everything is in progressional order. So I structured it to where, okay, day one, this is a brand new student to bachata. I'm not gonna come off with pow, do this fancy footwork thing in day one when we don't even know what the instruments are, we don't even understand the timing of the music, and we don't even understand how to dance with somebody. You know, like for example, when you do samba no pe, that's more of the Brazilian samba, that's more of an individual thing. Or I guess you say hip hop, that's more of an individual type dance. So it's not necessarily partner dance. So in partner dancing, the connection between you and that person is very important. But also, you know, the connection with the music. Before we start getting all these tricks, we need to understand these simple things about the dance first. So with the musicality section, you know, I break it down in order, you know, this is the first instrument, you know, in a progressive order. So that way once you get towards the lower half of the videos, everything that I'm talking about will make sense because, you know, it's like day one in math. You go, you know, addition, subtraction. You don't start off with calculus. You know, it's like, whoa. You know, you need to know your numbers first, how to add them, how to subtract them. Then you go division, multiplication, and then you get into geometry and algebra, or, you know, and all that stuff first. So that's the way I break it down. And it's user-friendly. So exactly how I teach in the workshops is exactly how I teach on the videos. You know, sometimes for the musicality section, I'll sit there in the chair, I'll hold up a big poster board, I'll have the instrument name, I'll have the timing of the instrument, I'll give examples, I'll show video clips of John Soriano and his band, you know, individually playing the instrument, so not only can you hear it, but now you can see it. Oh, that's what that instrument is, oh, okay. And then you become aware of all the different instruments and the different sounds, so now when you either see a live bachata concert or you're listening to songs, you can point things out and go, oh yeah, I recognize that, there it is right there. And then, you know, now you start to become more familiar with sounds and different rhythmic patterns within the bachata music. And then that's when the whole feeling comes in because you're aware of what the music is doing. And again, just comes from practice. Once you go through the musicality section, there's the timing section because obviously being on beat is very important when you're dancing because again, you're dancing to the timing of the music. So I just show you how to keep timing to different instruments, how to find the timing within different instruments. You know, so there's exercises and everything like that to do there. And then the partner work section is it's a partner dance, so it's very, very lead follow. You have to understand there's things for the leads, there's also things for the follows. Little tips on connection, frame, pressure, everything that will make a huge difference when you're social dancing, for example. Let's just say, you know, if you're having problems with a move and your hand is like this, and I was like, oh, well, you know, maybe put your hand like that. Oh, wow, that really makes a difference. So, you know, just the little things. I like to pay attention and break down the little details. And you're going to notice, again, those little details will make a huge difference just in the connection, and everything should be smooth. And the smooth ability, there's a new word for it, buddy. And the smooth ability of the dance. Because again, the dance should never be rough, jerky, you know, because that's just not, you know, the ladies, again, everything should be smooth and flowy. So understanding proper technique and timing also, and when to prep, you know, when you're doing turns and everything, that's very important, again, in the smooth ability of the dance. So I try to break down all these little tiny aspects of that in these videos. And then, you know, once you get to the forward section, now, you know, once you're comfortable with everything, you know, we'll do a couple of things, you know, now we start playing with the music and, you know, just making the dance a little more fun rather than just step, tap. We start doing different things with our feet. But again, it goes from 0 to 60 is for all levels because, again, the way that I teach is very different from everybody, you know, from every instructor. So it's just, again, just how I break it down so that way and you can be your first day off the street, never even heard of bachata, and you can come right in and learn, you know, learn progressively. And you know, the more you practice, the more you watch, the more you learn, the faster you grow as a dancer. And it's user friendly, for the leads and for the followers. There's stuff in there for everybody. Soy yo.
like a muscle.